Bong Joon-ho's The Host is a 2006 monster movie taking place in a city on the banks of the Han River in South Korea. When an American military pathologist asks his Korean assistant to dump bottles of formaldehyde into the river, a monstrosity of a creature evolves in the depths of the water, soon to wreak havoc on the lives of the humans living above the surface of its habitat. One day, when a small crowd of people taunt the creature by throwing garbage into the river, trying to get the creature to perform for them, it emerges from the water and an angry attack ensues. Park Gong-do, played by Kang Ho-song, becomes desperate when his daughter is taken by the creature, and in the end, finds himself having to kill the beast. Monstrous creatures like the one in The Host can be found in various works of fiction, but there's a certain challenge that comes with putting it in a film. For it to be scary, it needs to appear realistic enough to seem like an actual living thing. This can be especially tricky when the creature is created using computer-generated imagery, also known simply as CGI, when physical indexing of the creature's impact becomes vital to its lifelike nature. Not only does it have to be realistic, but it also has to create the illusion that it actually poses a threat to the humans, as if it can decide whether to let them live or die. Kristen Whistle, in her book Spectacular Digital Effects, CGI and Contemporary Cinema, describes this concept in depth when writing about the mediating and remediating of life and death. With this criteria in mind, let's take a look at how The Host makes its amphibious monster scary in just one scene, right at the beginning. The creature is introduced as hanging from the bridge, feigning the appearance of a land animal before morphing into various species, showing more and more adapted traits as the creature is physically revealed. Whistle describes these evolutionary advantages when she writes, "The design of the zoologically heterogeneous monster in The Host enables it to overwhelm its victims and elude capture. Having the appearance of an amphibious, freakishly mutated tadpole, The Host features four jointed jaws that open flower-like so that it can consume its large human prey, an anteater's long tongue, and a tail that enables it to hang upside down like an opossum, swinging gracefully from the beams of a bridge like a monkey, and grab and carry its victims over long distances. This, to Whistle, is what's called a vital figure." The creature charges forward recklessly, sending a human flying into the Han River with hardly any effort given. It's fast, large, and its abnormal conglomeration of animal body parts makes it terrifying to look at. Immediately we think, this creature can do some real damage, this thing could kill. To conceal the ontological differences between the living and the merely lifelike, Whistle writes, contemporary films portray vital figures as excessively and even terrifyingly alive. In order to appear as something beyond inanimate matter or immaterial code, that is, beyond an obvious computer-generated effect, these vital figures are designed, animated, and presented in a manner that links them ontologically to deadliness. The behavior of the creature is impossible to mistake. It's not excited, but angry and out for blood. The audience does not have to wait for the beast to develop to know that it is a threat, which is what makes its introduction so impactful. Its status as the physical antagonist is clear from the start, which is why the beginning is so important to establishing it as such. Further in the movie, it is revealed that the creature is the host of a virus, making it doubly threatening. But the beauty of our introduction to the creature is that the audience already finds the creature threatening without the virus. To Whistle, this is because of its control over life and death, an immortal, godlike power of destruction. Once we see the strength of the creature, we understand the potential threat it poses to the people by the river. Its ability to mediate mortal life and death is ultimately what causes us to feel anxious during its first attack. In order for these anxieties to have their full effect, the creature needs to look realistic, which is why Whistle introduces the concept of staging indexicality. She describes this concept as the promotion of a digital creature's embodied presence in a fiction world through the spectacular display of physical or indexical traces they appear to leave behind. The host includes multiple physical indexes of the creature's appearance, such as the blood on Park's face, the dirt it stirs up when climbing the bank of the river, the rumbling of a trailer it has trapped its victims in, the splash of the water as it returns to the river, etc. The fact that there are physical consequences of the creature's actions makes its existence within the diegesis impossible to deny. This principle is used in a variety of ways in a variety of genres. The 2013 sci-fi thriller Gravity uses physical indexing to establish the geographical location of the film, which is space. When Sandra Bullock pushes off of something, she floats through the air, reinforcing the spectacle of zero gravity despite the film being shot on Earth, where gravity is very much present. When paired with the performances of the actors, the host's monster is undeniably real in their world and is causing visible damage. Its strength and abilities, while it really is quite a clumsy monster, make it all the more frightening when you can see the fallout of its onslaught. This monster is one that defies reality, but feels and looks so real when placed within the world of the host. The way it looks and behaves from the get-go sets it up to be a worthy antagonist to Park, his daughter, and the citizens of the city. All of this is achieved through the magic of CGI, making its existence truly undoubtable and totally, completely terrifying.